All right, we've got Donald Cerrone, Cowboy Cerrone versus Miles Jury. I'm going to give you my prediction on this fight. I'm going with Cowboy in this fight. I think he's going to win. There's one thing that does concern me. I'm going with Cowboy because I feel like he's more experienced. He's faced tougher competition. That's why. I'm noticing that fighters that have faced tougher competition tend to be winning these fights. Except when they're kind of past their prime, over the hill. Now, you know, or changing organizations. That's another one. You know, the judging is different, scoring is different, the arena is different, and you know, things like that. You have to factor things like that in. But these are both UFC fighters. So, you know, Miles Jury is younger. I mean, he's new to the UFC, but it's not like he's coming from over from Pride or something, you know, years ago or something like that. That's what I'm talking about. So, I don't think Miles Jury's faced the competition that Donald Cerrone has faced. And Donald Cerrone is on an absolute terror. And so is Miles Jury. But the thing is, the one thing that does concern me with having to predict this fight, or which would concern anybody, which makes it difficult, is that Miles Jury's last two fights, you know, fighting Diego Sanchez and beating Gomi, that is impressive, but it's a big but because these guys, they're older, they've been around. I mean, Gomi, how many fights has Gomi had? And the sport has evolved and they're older. Or, I mean, are they really older? Has the sport evolved past them? It's hard to know. I mean, guys, I mean, I guess we're going to find out. It's hard to size them up. I mean, it would have been okay if he had, you know, beat Gomi and then fought another fighter that was up and coming or around his age and you know, a more current fighter, I guess I would say, somebody in their prime. But Cerrone definitely, I would say, is, you know, pretty much in his prime. He's on a tear. So if Miles Jury beats Cerrone, that's really going to say a lot. It helps size things up. Right now, when you're beating, you know, two guys that are veterans, and I don't know how long it was before, you know, he fought before that. I mean, it's, you know, 1 year in this sport is a lot. A lot can change in a year. 2 years is like an eternity. So, you know, so is Diego Sanchez on the way down? Is Gomi on the way down? I mean, it's safe to say that, you know, Gomi has been kind of over the hill for a while. And, you know, Diego Sanchez, I mean, he looked good when he fought El Nino. But that was a long time ago. And, you know, it's like, although he did look pretty good in that fight. He came back strong. Diego did not look good when he fought Miles Jury. So this is the one thing that does concern me. Diego Sanchez is a training partner of Donald Cerrone. And, I mean, Miles Jury made Diego Sanchez look easy. He made that fight look easy. But we don't know how does Cerrone match up with Diego Sanchez when they train. I don't really know. I mean, we don't know how they're training or what they're doing or anything like that. We just know that Diego's in great shape. We know that, cardio-wise, and that he's just a beast and a legend. But so it makes this fight tough to choose, but I'm kind of giving Miles Jury the benefit of the doubt with this prediction. I'm saying that Diego Sanchez is still really, really good fighter, and that Gomi is still really good, and that Miles Jury is just really good. That's kind of what I'm thinking. But that being said, I think Cerrone is still just on a tear, and I think he's going to be able to beat him. I think he's going to be able to beat Miles Jury. And if Miles Jury does win, I don't think it's going to be easy because Cerrone is, he's tough as nails. I mean, he really is. The only person that really made him look bad was Nate Diaz, which is a little strange. But I think a lot of that fight, what kind of caused that outcome was that Cerrone never got on top of Nate Diaz. You know, he knocked him down a bunch of times. Had he jumped on him, yeah, he might have got submitted. But I think his ego, he was just being stubborn. He just wanted to stand there and trade punches with Nate. And look what happened to him. But, you know, maybe if Benson Henderson stood there and traded strikes with Nate Diaz, maybe the fight wouldn't have gone so well for him. So, so that could have been a little bit of a strategy error on Cerrone's part. And so I'm kind of giving Cerrone the benefit of the doubt on that loss. But, you know, that being said, he's on a 5-fight win streak, I think. And he's looked great. So, fighters that fight a lot, they seem to just, when they're just on a tear like that, fighting very often, as long as they're not overtrained or killing themselves, having to cut weight, or cracking under the pressure, it's for the most part, it's a good thing. It keeps you real sharp. Training and everything, none of that is the same as actually fighting. We saw that with Nick Diaz and Strikeforce. I mean, he was fighting all the time. He was complaining about it, but really it just made him phenomenal. He got in there and it was like he was just on point. He didn't skip a beat from his last fight, whereas when you take time off, you kind of got to get back in your groove. And there's no way around that. I don't fight. It's not my brain that, you know, I would be putting in the octagon, so it's easy for me to say. But looking from the outside, if you're not getting knocked unconscious or really taking a beating in the fights, you ought to just get back in there and fight very often, because things really seem to favor you. And I think that's going to happen with Cerrone here, and I think he's going to win the fight. What's going to happen, I don't know. We're going to have to find out how good Miles Jury is, but this is definitely a close one, but I got to go with Donald Cerrone on this one. I'll see you guys later.